have been absolutely addicted to this raw cucumber salad. Basically, it's that viral raw carrot salad, but with cucumbers. It's amazing. Okay. The seeds make it a little tough. Here are the peeled cucumbers. I'm also going to add some toasted sesame oil. This is such a game changer. And then some soy sauce, that light. Then some rice vinegar. Toasted sesame seeds, and then some salt and pepper. That's it. So easy, so fresh, so simple. Love. And this is a whole cucumber. Amazing.
Seasoned meat, your favorite spaghetti sauce, shredded cheese. Mix this very well. And now for your Pillsbury biscuits, put in your filling. Just like this, and into a ball, place on your parchment paper and into the oven. They'll come out looking just like this. Add your garlic butter topping, and now you have the perfect savory snack. Enjoy.
All right, today's recipe could not be easier. It's my grandma's spicy pecans. I know they're a little expensive now, but I got this whole bag at Sam's Club for around $10, I think. I'll look it up and put how much it costs. If you have a Sam's Club or Costco membership, definitely get your nuts there. It's far cheaper. So another thing about this recipe is you make it in the microwave. Now, I have tried to do this in the oven, and it does not taste the same. So I stick with the microwave. You're welcome to bake it in the oven, but I do it the way my grandmama did. To a microwave safe dish, you're gonna put 6 tablespoons of water. You don't wanna use a bowl. You want it to be sort of shallow. A square one would be perfect, but this is what I have. Because I want the pecans to be able to kind of spread out and not be so on top of each other. So you're gonna put this in and then we're gonna add some seasoning. 3 tablespoons Worcestershire sauce. Did I do it right? Hot button topic here on TikTok. How to say this. 3 tablespoons of this. 3 tablespoons soy sauce. And a teaspoon of garlic salt. But I used unsalted butter because a teaspoon of this is pretty salty. All right, and that's literally it. So we're gonna microwave this for about 45 seconds. It ended up taking more like a minute and a half for the butter to melt. We'll make sure the butter is completely melted. Kind of give it a little stir. We're gonna add 4 cups of pecans. And give it a really good mix so that all of the pecans are cooking. And I know this sounds weird. The whole rest of the recipe is in the microwave too. They're gonna cook a total of 9 minutes in the microwave. So you're gonna do 3 minutes, take it out and stir. 3 minutes, stir, 3 minutes. And then they're done. See, you can make this like in a dorm room. All you college people out there. So it's gonna go in for 3 minutes.
First little stir.
Back in for 3 minutes.
So now it's been cooking for 6 minutes. You can see now the liquid is starting to soak into the pecans. Back into the microwave for 3 more minutes. Okay, while those are cooking, you're gonna wanna get a cookie sheet and line it with a paper towel. They're all done. You're gonna wanna stir it one last time. You have to let them cool before you eat them. They will not be crispy right away. Try to spread it out to a little even layer. You want them to have room to cool and get nice and crispy. And that's it. I hope y'all make them because our pecan tin every year. The pecans go in this tin. Still freaking good. I could eat this whole tray.
Currently my favorite high protein snack. Take some lettuce and tofurkey slices, add in a bit of cheese, wrap it up. Perfect little protein roll-ups.
This is my depression snack. It's so good. Everything bagel, Philadelphia cream cheese, and these flaming hot chips. Don't knock it till you try it.
Let's go. Let's make some cream cheese dough twist. After your dough's tenderized, roll it out. Stretch it to where it's even and symmetrical. Little twisty twist. All right, now it's time to give it a try. Cream cheese, crescent roll. You can't go wrong with this. Mr. Yum Yum, get you some. Lania, I approve.
I'm feeling snackish, so you know what that means? It's time for a Dollar Tree snack haul. A snack haul where I buy a bunch of random snacks from Dollar Tree and let you know whether they're worth it or not. These pitted snack olives caught my eye right away because they're in a little pouch. I've never seen olives on like a convenience package like this. So we're gonna open them up, see what we think. So there's not very much liquid in there. Oh, they smell really olivey. There's no pimento inside. Tastes just like an olive. They're a little extra slimy. If you're into snacking and olives, I guess this is for you. Sticking with the olive theme, I have these olive and oregano crackers. This is nice. There are multiple little snack pouches. So I think there are four different packages of crackers in there. They smell really well seasoned and olive oily. They have a lot of seasoning on each cracker. These are just okay for me. They're very much like just a basic cracker with a hint of seasoning on them. They're not as flavorful as I would have liked, but they're a nice cracker. Next, I got some sea salt bagel chips. I'm gonna try these with a little bit of cream cheese and everything but the bagel seasoning, because I think I'll like that a little bit better than just plain. These are just nice, crisp, plain crackers. Let me go ahead and put the cream cheese and seasoning on them. This is a really tasty snack, but also I don't know how it wouldn't have been with cream cheese and everything but the bagel seasoning on it. Last savory item, we're going to try this sour pickle. I've tried their spicy pickles that they've had there. I've tried the regular pickles they've had there, but never the sour ones. This is so good. Picture salt and vinegar chips in pickle form. It's really tangy and really tasty. I'm feeling snackish, so you know what that means? It's time for a Dollar Tree snack haul. A snack haul where I buy a bunch of random snacks from Dollar Tree and let you know whether they're worth it or not. These pitted snack olives caught my eye right away because they're in a little pouch. I've never seen olives on like a convenience package like this. So we're gonna open them up, see what we think. So there's not very much liquid in there. Oh, they smell really olivey. There's no pimento inside. Tastes just like an olive. They're a little extra slimy. If you're into snacking and olives, I guess this is for you. Sticking with the olive theme, I have these olive and oregano crackers. This is nice. There are multiple little snack pouches. So I think there are four different packages of crackers in there. They smell really well seasoned and olive oily. They have a lot of seasoning on each cracker. These are just okay for me. They're very much like just a basic cracker with a hint of seasoning on them. They're not as flavorful as I would have liked, but they're a nice cracker. Next, I got some sea salt bagel chips. I'm gonna try these with a little bit of cream cheese and everything but the bagel seasoning, because I think I'll like that a little bit better than just plain. These are just nice, crisp, plain crackers. Let me go ahead and put the cream cheese and seasoning on them. This is a really tasty snack, but also I don't know how it wouldn't have been with cream cheese and everything but the bagel seasoning on it. Last savory item, we're going to try this sour pickle. I've tried their spicy pickles that they've had there. I've tried the regular pickles they've had there, but never the sour ones. This is so good. Picture salt and vinegar chips in pickle form. It's really tangy and really tasty.
Making one of my favorite snacks of all time, lentil wraps. So it's 1 cup of red lentils, 2 cups of water, and then you let it soak for a couple hours. And then once that's done, you just transfer it to a blender. Gotta get all the little extras. And then also half of a teaspoon of salt. Then you just blend this up until it's completely smooth. And then just get your pan with a little bit of olive oil and kind of like spread it all out. Once the pan is heated on like medium heat, you just pour some in and then kind of try and like spread it out a little bit. And then you just cook it like a crepe. And you can kind of tell once it like starts to bubble and the edges stay together, you can flip it. And then that's it. It's super easy. And then it just makes these super nice, soft, and flexible wraps. And I just like to eat them just like this.
I have over 100 food allergies, so I can never find any snacks that I can have. And sometimes I do still walk up and down the aisles of the grocery store thinking that there's going to be something, but I just get disappointed every time because there's never going to be anything.
The reason it's hard for you to think of healthy snacks is because you're probably overthinking it. I'm obsessed with this combo and I always just eat it as a snack.
Romaine lettuce, these BNA chickpea snacks,
and then just a little bit of the Primal Kitchen Caesar. Now you're probably thinking, Maddie, that's a salad. And there you go again, just limiting your food choices.
I was 100 pounds heavier. My late night eating was out of control. I hated healthy food, but hated how I felt more. So I had to find something to eat that I could tolerate. Every night I would feast on butter-soaked popcorn, but what I realized I was craving was just the butter and the salt. So I would take frozen broccoli, microwave it, and coat it with butter spray and salt. Diet trolls, don't come at me for the amount of oil and salt. If you're a late night snacker, this is better than any chip or cracker. Over the last 20 years, I've upped my game as a food hacker and perfected this broccoli snack masterpiece. But they both hit the spot and make you feel amazing. Before I knew it, I was dropping pounds like crazy, and honestly, it's like the best thing ever.
If you're anything like me, you wake up craving savory food. Not oatmeal, not smoothies, but savory food. And I whipped up something this morning that was too good not to share. I'm gonna call this pizza eggs because it literally tastes like pizza without the grease, without the bloat, and without the cheese. Start off by boiling some Yukon Gold potatoes and then add garlic and oil to a pan. Chop up the potatoes and add this to the garlic. Season the potatoes with salt, red chili powder, Cajun, onion powder and nutritional yeast and some herbs. Then take a fresh tomato, add that into the mixture, and also add a handful of fresh basil. It's already gonna start smelling like a pizza. Lay the potatoes flat on the pan and start cracking some eggs in it. Then after that, you're gonna take some tomato slices and layer it on top of the eggs. Now you can just cover it and cook it to your desire. So if you like your eggs runny, don't cook it as much. If you like them tougher, cook it longer. Then I just cut it up like a pizza and serve it. This breakfast is so delicious. The eggs are so well cooked. The potatoes are crispy and seasoned and the tomatoes are juicy. It's healthy and balanced. And who says you can't have pizza for breakfast?
If you like spicy snacks, this is for you. We're making Alabama firecrackers, and they are so good. You just need some oil, ranch seasoning, some garlic powder, and red pepper flakes. That's the fire in the cracker. You'll make a marinade and then put in some saltine crackers, and you'll actually marinate these overnight for the best cracker. After they sit overnight, then you bake them for about 15 minutes at 250. Such a yummy snack.
Little evening craving, a little egg boil using my Deadly Hot promo code free ship. I just did like a tablespoon of butter and added in a little bit of seasoning, not the full packet. Bite the chip. I feel like putting it in the microwave, it gives it like a different consistency too. Some garlic in there.
so good.
In case like me, you occasionally run out of bread and then have a total panic about lunchboxes and breakfasts, you need to save this recipe. These are savoury muffins. They're really easy to make. You just take your dry ingredients, all store cover stuff, mix them up with some wet ingredients, skip them into a muffin tin, bake them for about half an hour. Look at that.